Hello and welcome, members of Dental Speaker Institute. Thank you so much for joining us. I'm excited to spend a few minutes with our friend and colleague, Penny Reed, today. Hey, Penny, welcome.
Hey, Vanessa, thanks for having me.
Absolutely. Thrilled to have you here and talk a little bit about eAssist. Before we go there, though, I wanted to give just a little bit of introduction. I think many of our colleagues know you because you've been a speaker and consultant for a lot of years. And for those of you who don't know, Penny is author of a book called Growing Your Dental Business and co-author of Persuade with a Case Acceptance Story. And of course has been at Jumpstart for multiple years and has helped us with our speaking competition and other parts of our meeting. And we just really love and appreciate you, Penny. And so looking forward to spending time with you.
Me too. Love and appreciate you as well and what you guys are doing, and happy to get to hang out with friends.
Oh yeah, so fun. And so fun for us to have a chance to talk about eAssist that we also love. And, you know, for me personally, eAssist means so much to me for a lot of reasons. I think they really awesome people that work through eAssist and that we've all come to get to know through Jumpstart. They are a founding sponsor, which means they have supported our Jumpstart journey for, well, even our upcoming fifth year. So for 5 years, they have been helping to support speaker and consultant education. And I just really appreciate that and appreciate them. And of course, in our industry, they do really big things and offer some amazing solutions. And that's what I was hoping today to just draw, shed a little light. So anyone who may know the name, but they're not entirely sure what eAssist does. And just thought we could spend a few minutes together and determine, but share, why it matters. Like, why does it matter to the typical speaker and consultant? And how can they plug the solution in with their audiences and the people that they work with, the dental professionals? So maybe we could start by shining a light on what the problem or the problems are that eAssist brings solutions for.
Absolutely. So our tagline, which I love marketing, our tagline is bringing peace of mind to dentists. And so how we came about, like the problem within the practice to solve, our co-founders, James Anderson and Sandy Odell, Dr. Anderson lost his office manager that did the dental billing. And he's located in Utah, and he was trying to find someone else to do that role. And he thought, well, I'll outsource it. Right. That's been happening in the medical profession for years. He couldn't find anybody.
Oh.
And so they set, had this vision. Hey, this is something that we could do. We might have, wouldn't it be something if one day we had 50 offices? Now we have almost 1600 dental billing offices. So that was in 2011. And so it's a definite challenge. Dental insurance. I became a dental office manager probably 28 years ago now, back before I'm sure that Windows had, was invented and that other dental offices had computers that had a mouse. Ours did not. We were still on DOS, right? Where you had to know the F, all those, hey kids, those young consultants that are tuning in, those little F function keys on the computer, they were actually there for a reason. Like we didn't have a mouse, we couldn't touch the screen. And so it was a passion of his, right? It's still the mission very much focused on, but it's gotten more complicated. There were not a lot of PPOs back then. I used to think that I knew a lot about dental insurance. And, you know, as a office manager, and then in my early years as a speaker and consultant, and then you throw in all the PPOs and all these different restrictions and laws that vary from state to state. And so as a consultant, I began to, so I'll tell you a little story, Vanessa, about how I met eAssist, if that works.
Please.
For you.
That'd be great.
It was 4 years ago this month, I did a meeting with a fellow consultant that used to be a coaching client of mine, Dr. Chris Griffin. He has a podcast. I think he's the 3-day dentist, just super great, lectures on efficiency, super smart guy. And so we put together a team beach weekend. It was a great reason to have a meeting at the beach in Florida. And we weren't going to have sponsors, and we decided to have one. And then he said, well, I work with this group called eAssist. And I was like, well, what do they do? And he told me, and he's in a small town in Mississippi, right? Where do you find, and when your person retires in Ripley, Mississippi, where do you find a competent dental biller, right? Sure. That knows all the ins and outs of the codes and how to get claims paid. And so Sandy came, and I believe her daughter worked for eAssist at the time. And my role at this meeting, he was talking about efficiency and I was talking about culture and how to work together better as a team. And she would come up at the breaks and she would say, I love all this. Like this, it's amazing how many of the things that you're talking about, these are the same values that we espouse at eAssist. So hit it off with her. And as I began to have, hey, any of us that have worked closely with dentists through the years, turnover sometimes happens. Yeah. And they face the same issue, right? Hey, we don't want to outsource it. Sometimes they would say, let's try to find someone. So sometimes we would, other times we would say, hey, in the interim, why don't you try outsourcing? And I would refer them to eAssist. So organically over the years, I began to develop a deeper relationship. It also for me as a coach really was helpful because not that I don't want to be helpful to clients, right? That was not my thing, right? It was not my level of expertise. And so I would want to be focused on, hey, you know, we set these goals. We're trying to think outside the box in the practice, you know, achieve new levels of success. And then we might not get paid, right? We might hit those production targets, or we just continued to have this gap at the front that we could not fill. And so it really allowed me to be able to focus more on the things that I could really be helpful with. And that was an area of the practice that not only did I not have to be so concerned with it, I got reports every day from the eAssist team about what they did the night before.
That's cool.
Right? How many claims were sent? How many were followed up on? What was neat? And it was this higher level of accountability than was going on within client offices. I mean, you know, normally what the doctor knows is, well, they're looking around at the team. She's with a patient. He's with a patient. She's on the phone. She's working hard. She's on the phone. She's working hard. She's checking people in and out. Well, they're always busy. And so I love the focus on results and begin to refer to them more. And I think that's probably the culture fit. And then the focus on results for me, it was just a great fit. And that's one of the reasons why I love to be able to talk about what we do at eAssist and how it can really help you as a speaker, coach, and consultant help your clients.
I love that. So if we went back and bullet pointed some of the benefits that came from there through that story would be an opportunity for outsourcing, right? So what one benefit was, you know, life happens and people move on, right? Things just happen. We have, that's like a part of business. And so, but it feels to me like when you outsource to a company like this, they keep the consistency. So you don't have to deal with it, right? You don't have to go find somebody new and train them. So you can outsource. There's that consistency. It evens out like the up and down of that. And then also the accountability piece. And I love that the focusing on the results and the maybe in some practices, they do that type of daily reporting, but
I had never seen it, you know, and there's weekly reports and things too. But it's you know, again, it's the, just that whole transparency is what we strive for. And I'll be the first to tell you, I think any company would tell you, you know what, we're not perfect, right? But sure. our goal is to always, you know, we have brand promises. And one of those is that we, you know, our goal is to keep your over 90 days outstanding insurance at zero, right? And it's part of our mission. It's part of our success consultants, what they're looking at all the time. And to help give feedback to the offices if they don't have the right documentation. It's, you know, we really are become another part of the team. And it was funny, thinking back to Dr. Griffin also, when he was talking about one of the reasons why he liked eAssist. And again, I think just that assurance to the doctor, which also brings peace of mind to us in supporting the doctors, was no maternity leave, right? They don't get transferred. And within, like we see that, I see that on the inside now. And these groups work together as teams. It's like, okay, if this person is going to be out, they're saying, hey, can you cover my office? And so again, I think bringing that, you know that it's handled. And then you also, you know, we're here to support you. And that's one of the things, even though I'm the director or actually the chief strategy officer, and I work a lot with other companies. I don't work as much individually with other consultants, but we want to hear from you, mm-hmm. right? If you see something or you have a question, we want to, you know, we're part of that team, and we'll get you connected, you know, if it's something ongoing or you just want more information about what we do. And so some of those issues, right, are to help your clients get paid. Not only what they rightfully deserve from the insurance company, we can take it that as far as the patient billing part too. So you can literally have it to the point where once the treatment is done and it's posted and the patient's walked out, that from that point until all the rest of the money comes in, that we can take care of that for you. And it's interesting, it's evolved. You know, one of the other challenges that I found as a coach was that often my clients, you know, these doctors, they go to school to be dentists. They don't necessarily go to dental school so they can learn how to use QuickBooks, right? So, you know, here they are, they have QuickBooks. They have no idea how to use it. And they might have a CPA, but they don't necessarily have someone to do their books, or even worse, they're letting someone who's got their hands in their practice management system, also same person, have the hand in QuickBooks, right? Which is a dangerous place to be.
Yes, yeah.
And so we also provide dental bookkeeping and dental accounting. Now we're not replacing your dental CPA, right? We work with you up to that point, but we even have checks and balances within our office that we will not have a team member that's working in Dentrix or whatever your practice management software is in posting payments. That same team member cannot be the one, even though they may have the skill set, that's doing your bookkeeping. So we can pay the bills, get all of the accounts reconciled so that the doctors can focus on more of what it is that they want. And again, coming back to us as consultants, we have less to worry about from the standpoint of, is there any funny business going on
right
within the practice? And you don't have to do both things, right? Maybe you don't want to outsource your dental billing, right? We still have bookkeeping services, yeah. Or credentialing. Mm-hmm. That has to be, and I can remember a couple of times that it happened. And I was a growing your dental business. I was focused on that aspect. I wasn't really focused on trying to be sure that all of my clients were currently credentialed with their PPO plans.
Right.
Well, if you've never had that happen to you before, where all of a sudden your client's like, what do I do? Susie, who used to work here, was in charge of credentialing. She's gone. And I didn't realize my credentialing expired with Cigna 6 weeks ago.
Yeah.
And so I have all these patients that are mad, right? Because they got out of, you know, what do we do about the write-offs? I'm supposed to be in network. It's just a mess. So that's another way that we can help.
You know, can I just interject? It feels like I'm thinking, as I'm listening to you, I'm thinking now it goes back to systems, right? And processes, like every mm-hmm. good practice management consultant will preach from their pulpit. And really what I see ECS doing here is taking that load of certain systems and being able to just have a well-oiled machine so that the doctor and their team can focus on other systems and their patients.
Absolutely.
Especially. So we have dental billing, we have insurance verification, we had credentialing, and we had accounting. Did we get them all?
So we also have a new service that we launched after the first of the year. We've been a little hush-hush about it because, well, you know, if you launch a new service and it's really good, guess what happens? Whoosh, right? You know, there's that whole trying to manage growth. And we have an amazing team that really, and I think one of the things that's the secret sauce with the assist is our success consultants. You know, they're their own entrepreneurial minds. And so one of them had this idea and she said, you know what, we can we can grow, eAssist can grow if we help practices keep their schedule full. And so this is not a patient relationship management software. There's no software involved in this other than the practice management software or the link that we have with the office, but it's called Full Schedule. And so, and there's information about that on the website as well. And we help keep the schedule full, the hygiene schedule. And it's interesting as it evolves and we're listening to our clients. We have some that are saying, hey, would you call our outstanding treatment plans? We're booking implant cases, but it's just more of a concierge level. You know, again, we're functioning as part of the team. So it's really exciting to see that because it's veered, you know what I'm saying? We're kind of dipping our toe in something that is outside of the direct revenue cycle management. But again, you teach your clients how to schedule effectively. You teach them how to have great telephone skills. And if we're super busy, sometimes we don't have time to focus on the important but not urgent, and those phone calls may not be made. And I'm not saying as a substitute for an automated platform that's sending, you know, text reminders and things like that. This is, again, an extension of the team and helping the practice. You know, I had a coach years ago, not the coach that really introduced us, but my first business coach. He talked about focusing on your genius work. And so I think that's really one of the benefits of helping eAssist helps doctors do that, but we help the speakers and consultants do that too. If there are some of these, and maybe this is your niche, right? Which I would say, hey, if it is, it's like we've talked about with speaking, there's more work out there to be done in helping in this dental industry than any one company could do, right? But unless this is your jam, right? Unless you teach people, you know, how to do this, or you have your own outsourced dental billing company, this really takes a weight off and allows you to be a hero, you know, with your clients, because that part's taken care of. Dentists are, they're stressed, right? Sure. I mean, they are. I can remember coming in as an office manager. My dentist hired me. His wife had been my track coach and volleyball coach. I mean, I knew them. And I remember coming on and thinking, my mission is to try. I mean, yeah, I want to help the practice grow. I want to help him make more, but he's a ball of stress, right? He deserves to not be so stressed out. And I think ultimately at the end of the day, that's why all of us are here, right? As the speakers and consultants in this industry, is we're trying to help dentists solve what problems they have.
Because we want them to be able to function through their unique brilliance as well, right? Like going Absolutely. Back to that concept, and it would be unusual for the dentist to be most passionate about billing, right?
And so right, to have to be worried about it when they're not, yeah. you know what I'm saying? When they're not yeah. chairside and not at the office, we want them to have a life, right? Happy dentists have happy dental teams and happy patients, and they make yeah. more money. And if there's anything I think that I have an awareness of, and I still have a handful of coaching clients myself, it's this last year was stressful. I think it really, for a lot of us, brought into maybe because we had too much time to think. I don't know. It's like, all right, what is most important? How do, when some of this COVID stuff dies down, how do I want to spend my days, right? My time and my focus, and anything that I don't have to do, I'd like to find somebody that enjoys doing it and can do it better than I can.
Yes. And to really grow any business, we have to grow a team and get those resources in place too, to help us be able to, so that the dentist can just focus primarily mm-hmm. on their unique brilliance, and each of the team members be able to focus in their unique brilliance. I love that. And bringing that back mm-hmm. to the speakers and consultants, for those who aren't billing experts, or who are, you know, or speaking, and their expertise is in many other areas, this is such a great tool to have in their tool belt, so that when they see that their audience members, their consulting clients, would benefit from something like this. You know, before we go, I want to just kind of wrap back around to our speakers and consultants. I know you had mentioned to me in the past there were some opportunities for consultants to collaborate with eAssist. Could you tell us a little bit more about that?
Absolutely. So I remember being at it may have been the Academy of Dental Management Consultants meeting when I first met Dr. Anderson. He was there. Sandy Odell was there. By the way, Sandy is still very much with us, in case you're going, why is Penny here and Sandy's not here? Sandy is off somewhere creating some magic somewhere else within eAssist or with an eAssist client.
We send her hugs and kisses.
I can assure you, you have not seen the last of Sandy. So,
and we love Penny too. So this is awesome.
Yeah, other ways. So I can remember at that meeting, and it's been a couple of years ago, Dr. Anderson talking about, so, hey, it's so great to meet you. And, consultants are so important to us, and what can we do to help? And we have some ideas. And one of those ideas is we want to launch an educational platform. All right. Well, roll the clock forward in late September of this past year, when he reached out to me and said, hey, what would you think about coming? And I had a couple of conversations with Sandy. We'd had some meetings to say, all right, if we were going to do this, what would it look like? And then the opportunity came and he said, hey, how would you like to come and do it? And I said, wow, I think that sounds so awesome, but I couldn't do that and run Dental Coaching Institute. And he was like, well, we want you. We also want you to work on these other things. So we have launched, and it's called dentalzing.com. It's a quirky name. Had a little bit of input in picking it, but it's memorable, and it's in its infancy. I mean, you can go out there now. It's already out there. It's an educational platform, and our goal is that it will be different, or we kind of have a little bit of a different take. Right now we've got members of the eAssist team, and Dr. Roy Shelburne has been doing work with us. Lois Banta is on the eAssist team. I'll be doing some courses, but it's not just about eAssist doing courses and, hey, we want you to come, right? We were creating an environment. We put a container out there to put things in. Really what I would love to hear from you guys that are tuning in, the speakers and consultants, this is a place for you to come and educate your audiences, people that haven't met you yet. It's a marketing opportunity. It's a revenue sharing opportunity. So again, that abundant level of thinking, we believe that there's more work out there to be done than any one consultant can do. So if you have a message, right, courses that you want to teach, courses that you already have, we want to, we want to be able to help not only give you exposure, what is the too much exposure is a bad thing, right? If you're left outside and it's 30 below and you don't have a coat, not that kind of exposure,
but exposure
but also
is a good
an opportunity
thing.
For yeah. you to earn, to earn money doing that as well. So super excited about that. Again, it's like in its little bitty teeny baby face. The website
just
launched.
Penny, let me just interject. We find out about Dental Zing on the eAssist website, or
you actually go to dentalzing.com. It's so new. We don't even have it listed on dentalbilling.com. It has its own website. It will cross link over. And so for the clients, for the clients of eAssist internally, they will get discounts on some of the courses that are out there. So today would be the casting call that I would say, if you are interested in having programs on the site, I'm your girl. Let's talk about what you want to teach. If you've done programs for years, great. If you've never done one, that's good too, right? This is just a chance to help provide more education out there for the industry, more exposure for you, more income for you. So
that's
super
fabulous.
Excited about that.
So if anyone wants to find out more about this, and I did go to dentalzing.com and found the site, Penny, you're penny.reed@eAssist.com.
penny.reed@eAssist.me.
And Reed is R-E-E-D, penny.reed@eAssist.me. .me, not .com. I said it wrong. .me. That's awesome. And I know that you had also shared with me a PDF resource to share.
Yes. So it's what every doctor needs to know to get paid. So I thought with some of the eBooks that we had, I chose this one because once again, maybe everybody isn't. I used to be so against outsourcing, like adamantly against it. Even when Dr. Griffin told me about eAssist before I met Sandy, I was like, I've been an office manager you don't outsource that. You know, I was just had this little,
you know what? It's kind of like when you were telling us before how you were in the world of DOS and then that Windows thing came along. We got on board.
Yeah, I was like, I don't need a stinking mouse. I'll just use the F keys, right? Yeah.
And then like outsourcing is kind of awesome.
Outsourcing is completely awesome. So what every doctor needs to know to get paid here. One of the reasons that I pick that is often it's because the insurance verification wasn't done, right? Or it's because of the lack of proper clinical documentation. Maybe the team doesn't know how to do a soap note or they don't know what needs to be attached. Ultimately, we're here to help, awesome. Right? We want to be that resource. And so there's some great information in there for other speakers and consultants. I think that's something that you could learn, look at and give a tip or two, or maybe forward it to a client. So you click on it and then just enter your name and email address. It's a free resource for you. One of the other things, and I may get in trouble, like we might be about to go into overtime here, but if I could share putting my speaking and consulting hat on. If you're thinking, okay, I'm not really sure about, or I already recommend, you know, the outsourcing, but when are the opportune times that you might want to consider doing that? Well, one of the things that I've seen more, and I haven't seen any hard stats, but just like that general vibe, right, that we get about what's happening, there have been a lot of practice acquisitions that have taken place over this last year, right? I have former clients that I've seen that are starting small, you know, like mid-market groups, you know, maybe they're not DSO level yet. So when you acquire another practice and their dental billing systems are a hot mess, mm-hmm. that's a prime time to say, okay, how can I help, you know, as a coach, how can I help these offices
awesome.
Get some traction quickly.
Good point.
That's become a big lead source for us, right? That's so awesome. In any sort of practice in transition, trying to solve that problem. Sure. And then I think the other is also the realization, and most of the time doctors don't know this, not because you doctors are not super smart, right? You're just in so many different places. Is that it really all starts when we're talking about getting that revenue cycle management in order. If the patient's benefits are not verified, right? They don't have the plan that they had, that starts this whole chain reaction of the claim being delayed or not paid. And that's one of the things that often in the practice, the team will say, well, we just didn't have time. So if you're not really, you kind of want to dip your toe into the shallow end of the pool to see what it would be like, that could be an area as well that could be helpful. But again, going back to the, you know, consultants and coaches that, and I'm sure you've seen it happen. If you've got clients that are bringing on multiple other offices, that's a place where we can really get in and make a difference quickly.
Thank you. I just want to encourage anyone who wants to explore more on these topics, learn more about eAssist and what they share, but like how specifically eAssist can work with you as a speaker or consultant, to reach out to penny.reed@eassist.me. The website, we can see there behind her in her fancy office building, she's in there.
Yeah, you could just scan like right up here by my head, the QR code.
Unless they see me up here with my phone.
Unless they changed it.
Yeah. Dentalbilling.com will take you to the website. I will put the links for Dental Zing and that PDF in the comments below.
Thank you.
Penny, thank you. I'm going to ask you one more question before we go. But I wanted to thank you so much for coming and sharing time with us. We always enjoy spending time with you, and it's so good to see you. We love you as a member of our community, and thank you for supporting speakers and consultants and being here to help today for eAssist. One final question for you before we go, and I'm going to ask for like a short, sharp one line bottom line. I'm going to give you a second to think on this, but for the speaker and consultant, if you could sum it up into one thing they need to know about eAssist or how it can help them or their clients, I'm just throwing this at you out of left field. Is there one thing, a one line bottom line for them to take away? About eAssist, how it can be helpful to them or to their clients. Mm-hmm. Bottom line.
So what I would say is, well, a couple of things, and it all kind of comes together, because most of you that are watching, you know, you're an independent, or if you're not, right, you're probably, what you earn is directly tied to the work that you do, right? So just being, allowing you to free up the brain space to focus on your genius work, right? And not have to worry about this part for your clients, and really, you know, just kind of taking it back to remembering why we started, right? That we're here to help. And, you know, that's the exact same thing, that whole, when I saw the tagline for ES, you know, bringing peace of mind to dentists, right? It's like, oh, that sounds so cute, but that really, and I can tell you this now that I'm on the inside, there's a lot of work that goes into just staying on top of not only doing it, but doing it well, and service recovery when we need to, right? So it's not just a phrase that we say about bringing peace of mind. It's something that we work on every single day. And a lot of that is, you know, ultimately at the end of the day, all of the work that we do for the clients, right, as speakers and consultants, and then all of the work that goes into what happens in the practice, if they do all that work and then they don't get paid what they could be getting paid, it makes me really sad, right? So, I mean, we've got an opportunity to make a huge difference in all the different things that we do. But I think at the end of the day, being sure that doctors and their teams get paid for the work that they did and doing everything that we can, that's one of the best things that we can do for them. So I hope that answered your question.
I think so. Thank you so much for being here. We appreciate it. Appreciate your time.
Oh, thank you. I think I heard a wee bit of a Southern drawl. Do you have a Southern drawl, or have I rubbed off?
Only when I hang out with Southerners.
Okay. Y'all, thank you for having me. I love spending time with you, and just what a great organization and program that you have. And super excited to be of help. And in all seriousness, I need you. I not only need Vanessa, I need those of you that are tuned in, that have a message to share, have education to share.
Bring it to Dental Zing.
Yeah, bring it to Dental Zing, or email me.
Penny.reed@eassist.me. And on that note, thank you so much, Penny. Thank you guys for hanging with us and being attentive. And until next time, be well.
Thank you for having me. Bye-bye.